was trying to change my life around. I lost my brother. I lost my mother. I lost my ex-wife. And I'm doing the best to handle it. But I'm just tired of the streets. And I'm 55 years old. I have a son. And I have 4 grandchildren. Which my grandchildren are homeless now. It'll work out if I be strong.
I lost my son. I lost everything I own. It's hard, you know, and I haven't even got nowhere to even mourn. I don't have no time for that. You know, I gotta overcome my homelessness before I can sit down and even get my mind really clear. It's a lot. It's too much, really. It's too much for me.
I recently was evicted from my apartment. I lost my job. I'm in recovery.
Worked all my life, you know what I mean? Had everything. And then all of a sudden.
There's over 7,000 homeless people every night. There are less than 900 beds available. When I look at the reality of the situation here in Los Angeles, and especially here in the San Fernando Valley, my heart breaks.
Each and every one of them has a story, and their stories are filled with a lot of pain. There's a lot of hurt. There's a lot of suffering.
January 2016, they pulled the rug out from under me.
5 years ago, I lost my house, and due to my income, I couldn't no longer pay it.
I look at them, and I know that at one point, you know, they were little babies, and they were children with hopes and with dreams.
Homeless is a state or a condition that they're in. It's not who they are. For whatever reason, we don't know what to do with those people, which I hear oftentimes. When in reality, what those people need is love. They're human beings. So 7 years ago, I had the privilege of starting Hope of the Valley Rescue Mission. It was started primarily because I really wanted to see a rescue mission established here in the San Fernando Valley that's rooted here in the valley. There really isn't another one.
Usually the first service that guests are waiting for is the shower program, and so they're put on a list, first come, first serve, to be able to take a shower, and we do provide everything they need to be able to do that, including clothing.
The shower makes me feel like I got a purpose.
It gives me a feeling there's hope. I know I can wake up tomorrow and I got a meal coming. I got a shower.
We have also what we call an outreach meal program.
Let's just put it all in a pot, call it shepherd's pie.
When I can give someone a hot meal, their face changes, their disposition changes. Now all of a sudden, they don't have to think about their hunger. They can think about something else.
We want them to feel like the human beings that they are. Seeing the joy come back into their eyes again and see the light. You know, we're here to make sure that they know that they're loved. You know, people need to know that they're loved.
What they give me personally is some hope, I will say, and truthfully say, saved my life.
And this place was kind enough to open their arms to me again and give me a second chance, because I had nowhere to go.
This place over the valley has helped me out a hell of a lot.
There's nothing more painful than looking into the eyes of a child or a mother or another human being that wants change, but we don't have the resources to help them. And so I'm not afraid to ask, because when we work together, we can overcome the impossible.
I'm only human after all. I'm only human after all. Don't put the blame on me. Don't put the blame on me. I'm only human after all. I'm only human after all. Don't put the blame on me. Don't put the blame on me. I'm only human, I do what I can. I'm just a man, I do what I can. Don't put the blame on me. Don't put your blame on me.